Hi, it's Ashley from Sweet Dreams Bake Shop, and welcome back to my channel where I make a lot of cake and cookie decorating tutorials, as well as give a lot of baking business tips. Now, I know this is a very short video today, but I'm going to pack it full of information all about cake jars. So what I'm first doing here is I'm starting off by making some red velvet, and I've never made red velvet cake on my channel before, but this was a really, really great recipe. I will link it down in the description box below. Super, super stable. Awesome for heavily decorated cakes, even using things like fondant and stacking, which is always a huge plus for me. So the first of my tips for cake jars is choosing the correct type of cake. Now, here's the thing, there is no right or wrong type of cake. However, I like to pair certain fillings with certain cake types. So if I'm using a really stabilized cake like this recipe, I'm going to use a buttercream, like an American frosting, Italian meringue, or Swiss meringue buttercream. If it's a lighter and fluffier cake, I'm going to use something that's a little bit lighter as well, like a mousse or a really soft ganache. The next thing I want to talk about is the type of jars that you use. Now, this jar that I used actually wasn't the best choice. You want to go for something that has a fairly large opening so that you can lay those pieces of cake down fairly simply. And whenever I'm filling these cake jars, I want to make sure that it looks good from the side. So you want to see those really clear layers of cake, then filling, and cake, and filling. And in order to do that, it's really important that you have a jar that can facilitate that. And moving right along, in general, I'm creating cake jars because I have all of these cake tops and I don't want them to go to waste. So just how long can you actually store them for? I would say you are good to go quality-wise and food safety-wise for a solid week in the fridge. And for my final tip, let's get right into the pricing. So I would not offer these as a custom order. I would only offer these as a stock order and they would just be ready as I have them. They're also super easy to make and it's really about covering your costs of the jar because as best as we try, there is some waste that does happen where cake scraps might get thrown out or buttercream that isn't being used. So essentially you're getting a whole other product out of something that might have just gone to waste. So I personally would just price them for quick sale while still making sure that you're making a little bit of a profit as well. Now let's get into the subscriber submission of the video. I absolutely love this. If you guys saw my video from the other day, I made a Grinch cake just like this, and I believe the subscriber followed my tutorial, and I'm not only impressed with the way that it looks, but I'm also impressed with how quickly that cake got done after I posted that. So thank you so much for sharing that with me. Go and check them out on Instagram. Drop them a like, drop them a comment. And if you want to be the next subscriber submission of the video, then please follow me at SD Bake Shop on Instagram, where you can either tag me in a photo or send me a photo. Any and all dessert levels are welcome. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe so you can be part of the Sweetie Fam. Right now, I'm uploading weekly, so make sure you hit that notification bell so you know when I upload. Also, be sure to comment, request, or ask a question. I love hearing from you guys. Bye!